Good morning to all of you. Today we can see the topic on system of rice intensification, that is SRI, method of rice cultivation. First of all, we can see the introduction. As the SRI method was developed in 1983 by French Jesuit Father Henri de Lavallieni in Madagascar. And this system is widely used in the Andhra Pradesh. In SRI is also called as the less water method of produce of rice, and it has been tested in China, Indonesia, Cambodia, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and Thailand. The system of rice intensification, that is SRI, is the farming methodology aimed at the increasing the yield of rice produced in the farming, it is the low water labor intensive method that uses the younger seedlings singly spaced and typically hand seeded with the special tools. So in the SRI method, the method of popularly used in the rice cultivation, where the main aim of SRI method, that is use of less water, then less labor, then also the less seed, and the mostly the young seedlings are majorly used, or the yes, only one seedlings can be used for the transplanting, and typically we forbid management. In SRI method, the hand weeding or the special tools are used. And then next point, that is in the system of rice intensification, is a new and promising resource saving method of growing rice under the irrigated rainfed condition. That's why the SRI method of rice cultivation is also called as the resource conservation technology. And then among the studies, the number of countries have shown the significant increase in the rice yield with the substantial savings of seeds, that is 80 to 90% of the seed inputs are saved, then water, that is 25 to 50%, and the cost saving, that is 10 to 20% compared to the conventional methods. This is the major benefits of SRI method, that is saving of 80 to 90% among the cost of seed. Then water cost, that is in terms of irrigation or the water, that is 25 to 50%, and the cost of total cost of cultivation of rice, that is minimized in SRI, that is 10 to 20% compared to the conventional method. The next one, that is SRI, is not a technology but the set of simple idea and the principles that helps to produce more productive and the robust plants. As we discuss on the next slide, that is SRI is the practice of cultivation of rice, not a technology, or it is a resource conservation technology, or the part of cultivation of the rice, which were the simple ideas or the practices or the principles that can be used for the production of more rice yield, especially number of tillers per plant is more over the conventional rice cultivation. And then also the plant growth is vigorous, then the number of panicles are healthy, then the number of seeds per plants, then number of tillers are the, and then also the root development, it will be more versus the conventional method. Then average yield obtained in this SRI method, that is 80 to 100 times more over the conventional method of rice cultivation, that is 7 ton per hectare in a SRI method over the 4 to 5 tons per hectare in the conventional. Then in the SRI method produces more tillers, that is 30 to 50 commonly, around the 80 to 100 tillers for the individual plants. This is the 30 to 50 tillers per plant, that is commonly found in the conventional method, but in case of SRI, it is 80 to 100 tillers for the individual plants. Next one, with the positive correlation with the between the tillering and grain filling is found in the SRI method, then the plants are different and more effective root systems are observed in the SRI method. Then system is also, the SRI system is also called as the resource conservation technology, And the three system saves labor, water, seed, fertilizers and the pesticides. Hence it is called as the resource conservation technology. And this system gives the 10 to 15 times more yield of the rice over the conventional method, that is in conventional, that is 4 to 5 times. In this three method, only field is moisture or the wet condition will be maintained without flooding. This is important, that is the difference between the three cultivation and the over the conventional method. In conventional method, that is field should be kept under the flooded or waterlogged conditions over a long period of time. But in the three method, only the field is moisture or the maintain the wetting or drying conditions without flooding helps to, because of this maintaining the wetting and drying conditions, it helps to reduce the formation of nitrous oxide and the methane gases that are responsible for the global warming. Then also three system consists of the planting of only one seedlings per hill over the conventional method was planted 2 to 3 seedlings or sometimes 3 to 4 or 5 seedlings per hill are transplanted in the conventional method, but in case of three system transplant only one seedlings per hill. The three method does not require puddling operation, that it means reduces the cultivation or tillage practices and ultimately increases the farmer's rice crop yield or the income. This is a part of introduction about the three of the system of rice intensification. Next point, that is advantages or merits of three method over the conventional. Here we can see the first point, that is half of water requirement compared to the conventional method, as the less water is required in the three system because of in three method or the system which where the wetting and drying or the soil kept under saturated or the moisture conditions without flooding. That's why the half of water required in the three method over the conventional. Then seed requirement are required in the three that is only 5 kg per hectare, which reduces the cost of seed and other expenditure over the conventional. But in case of the conventional method, the seed rate required per hectare, that is 100-120 kg per hectare, but in case of three is only 5 kg per hectare is sufficient. Then number of tillers per plant are more in the three, that is up to 50 tillers. Over the conventional, it was only 25 tillers per plant because of this mechanization. Results in the compaction and affects the growth of plants. Then more number of grains per panicle than the conventional method. In weight of grains per weight of grains is also more because of healthy plants in the three method than the conventional. Then early harvesting, that is 10 to 15 days earlier in the three method of rice cultivation and then the conventional. And the yield of rice obtained in the three method, that is 10 to 15 times more than the conventional. These are the advantages or the merits of this three system over the conventional. Here we can see how the rice plant can more rewarding as they need have the different different principles. First of all, we can see here the more grain yield per fertile tiller, more tiller per plant, then the increase and the bigger hill stations. That is the number of tillers, number of plants per unit area, then number of grains per plant, then larger grains or heavier grains are observed or found in the three method, and then more well filled fertile panicles which form from the tillers, and that plants put out, and then healthy and strong root system below the ground of for each plant is observed in the three method of rice cultivation. And then also the these benefits are work on the four main principles. These are principles in the three method, that is healthier early growth of the crop or crop establishment, reduce the competition between the plants, healthy soils, rich in organic matter, and then moist soils or the water management. These are the main principles which will be get the major benefits in this three method. Then you can see in the next slide, that is a comparison of three versus conventional method of rice cultivation. is as follows. As the exact particulars, that is spacing, number of plants per meter square, number of seedlings per hill, number of plants per acre, then seed requirement per acre. Here we can see first point, that is in case of spacing, in conventional method that is 15 by 10 centimeter, but in tree method that is wider spacing, that is 25 by 25 centimeter. Because of this closer spacing, there will be the more competition among the plants with respect to the nutrient, moisture, light, space, then ultimately reduction the yield of the crop, and then also number of tillers, the number of panicles, length of panicle. But in case of the tree method, that is wider spacing, that is 25 by 25 centimeter, it will get better results regarding the tiller numbers, then number of panicles, number of grains per panicle, and finally the yield of the crop. And the number of plants per meter square in conventional method, that is 66, and in case of tree method, that is only 60. The number of seedlings per hill, that is transplant per hill, that is in conventional method that is 3, and in tree method that is only 1. The number of plants per acre in conventional method that is 7,92,000, but in case of tree method that is 6,04,000. There is a difference between the number of plants per acre. This is highest in the conventional than the tree because of the closer spacing are observed or are found in the conventional than the, and in case of the tree, that is wider spacing. Then seed requirement per acre in the conventional method, that is 20 kg per acre, that is 20 kg, and in case of tree method, that is only 2 kg. This is a less required or less use of the seed in the tree method. This is the major difference between the three method versus the conventional method. Next point, the way we can see the detail about the how the rice cultivate in the tree method. That is first point, nursery management. Among the nursery management, that is first point, that is selection of seed and the seed rate, then seed treatment, and next one, that is preparation of nursery, and then preparation of field. First of all, we can see the selection of seed and the seed rate. In this method, the tree method, that is 5 kg seed is required to raise the seedlings for the 1 hectare. But in case of the conventional method, that is 100 or 60 to 100 kg seed rate is required to raise the seedlings for 1 hectare. Then seeds are true to type, healthy, viable, and they have the high germination percentage. This is the selection of seed and the seed rate. It is seed rate required for the raising of seedlings per hectare in the tree method, that is only 5 kg. This should be selected as per the prototype or the healthy, then viable, and have high germination percentage. Second point, that is seed treatment. Seeds are treated with thyrum, captan, or the carbendazim at the rate of 3 gram per kg of seeds for the control of bacterial diseases. The seeds are soaked with 3% brine solution, that is 300 gram common salt, in 10 liter of water for the control of blast disease. This is a major disease of rice. Then floating seeds on the surface of water should be removed in the brine solution treatment. The seeds are settled at the bottom, should be washed 2 to 3 times with the clean water and dried in the shade for 20 hours. And the seed is then soaked with clean water for 24 hours. Then seeds are also treated with emulsion at the rate of 5 gram per kg or 5 gram per 10 kg seed in 10 liter of water, and also treated with the Azotobacter or Azospirillum or the PSB biofertilizer at the rate of 25 gram per kg of seeds. These are the seed treatments which should be given for before raising of the rice seeds or before sowing of the seed. Next one, the preparation of nursery. Wide nursery beds are prepared and covered with the plastic seeds. You can see here in tree method, the nurseries are prepared that is wide and then covered with the plastic seeds, and 20 meter square area of the nursery is sufficient to transplant the seedlings in one for 1 hectare area. But in case of the conventional method, that is the area of nursery, that is 500 meter square. In depth of that is 25 to 30 meter square. But in case of Sri method, that is only 20 meter square area of nursery is sufficient to transplant or 1 hectare area. Then make the holes on the plastic sheets. We can see here, first of all, we can prepare the wide nursery beds, then covered with the plastic sheets. Then the area of nursery is required for raising seedlings per hectare, that is 20 meter square. And then make the holes on the plastic sheets for the better drainage of water. And then place the wooden frame. You can see here photographs. First of all, we can have to prepare the beds, wide beds of the nursery, and then place the plastic sheets. And then above the plastic sheets, you have to place the wooden frame or the iron frame on the nursery beds. Then add sieve or the fine powder from FOM sand or the soil with the ratio of 1:1:1. And then incubate it with warm and or moist place, place for the sprouting for about 36 to 48 hours. And the pre-germinated seeds are uniformly broadcast on the beds. And then seeds are covered with the soil or fine powder form of FOM. And then gently sprinkle the water on beds. And then covered with the beds with paddy straw material for 4 to 5 days to prevent the seed damage by birds or also from the ants. And after 4 to 5 days, paddy straw are covered with the beds and apply regular water as per the growth of seedlings. And in this method, seedlings are ready for transplanting within 8 to 12 days. This is the detailed information about the preparation of nursery. That is, first of all, wide nursery beds are prepared and covered with plastic sheets. And the area of nursery is sufficient to transplant 1 hectare area, that is 20 meter square. Then make the holes on the plastic sheets for better drainage. Place the wooden frame or the iron frame on nursery beds. Then add the sieve or the fine powder form of FOM sand soil with the ratio of 1:1:1. Then incubate it in a warm, moist place for the sprouting of the seed, that is 36 to 48 hours. Then pre-germinated seeds are uniformly broadcast on the beds, and the seeds are covered with the soil or the fine powder form of FOM are used to cover the seeds. And then gently sprinkle the water on the beds, and the beds with the paddy straw material for 4 to 5 days are covered to prevent the seed damage by the birds or also from the ants. And after 4 to 5 days, paddy straw are removed from the beds and apply regular water as per the growth of seedlings. In this method, the seedlings are ready for transplanting within 8 to 12 days. Next point, that is preparation of field. That is, 1 to 2 deep plowings are necessary to expose or to remove the rhizomes and suckers of the weeds as well as the control of insect pests. Then followed by the 2 to 3 harrowing operations are required or carried out as well as the clod crushing operation as to make the soil free from the clods. The incorporation of the FOM compost or the crop residues at the rate of 10 to 15 ton per hectare for enrichment of the organic matter and the as well as the balanced supply of the nutrients. And this saturate the field before transplanting without flooding. And the field is kept moisture or the underwetted condition without flooding. This is important point, that is preparation of field, which we have the plowing operations 1 to 2 deep for exposing the or the control of the weeds as well as the insect pests, and followed by 2 to 3 harrowing operations are carried out, and then clod crushing to make the soil free from clods, and afterwards you have to incorporate or apply the FOM compost or the crop residues at the rate of 10 to 15 ton per hectare, and then make the soil saturate before the transplanting without flooding. Next point, that is transplanting. The transplanting should be done when the seedlings are ready for transplanting. The seedlings are uprooted carefully on the nursery beds without damaging the roots. Then banana leaf seeds may be used for lifting the seedlings below the root system as to can carry to the main field. And in this method, the seedlings are transplanted after 8 to 12 days after raising of the seeds on the nursery. But in case of this conventional, that is 34 to 45 days, old seedlings are used, or this seedlings are ready for transplanting. In Depak, that is 11 to 14 days. But in case of Sri method, within a short period of time, you have to get the seedlings are ready for the ready to use, or they are ready for this transplanting. The seedlings are transplanted per hill are only one in the Sri method of rice cultivation. But in case of conventional, that is 3 to 4 or 4 to 5 seedlings per hill should be transplanted. But in case of Sri method, there is only one. The seedlings are transplanted at the depth of 2 to 3 centimeter to avoid the transplant seedlings more than 2 to 3 centimeter. Otherwise, the seedling establishment is delayed, or the mortality as well as reduces the tillering habit. Each seedlings have the 2 to 3 leaves and the 15 inch height are the ideal for the transplanting. The seedlings are transplanted with the spacing of 25 by 25 centimeter or 30 by 30 centimeter. This is wide spacing over the conventional method. And then immediately after transplanting, light irrigation should be applied as the to make the soil saturated with the flooding. Next point, that is fertilizer management or nutrient management. Incorporate FOM or compost at the rate of 10 to 15 ton per hectare, as well as green leaf manure as a glyricidia is used as the rate of 3 to 4 ton per hectare in the soil at the time of land preparation as a source of organic matter, as well as enriching the or sequestering the carbon in the field. Then application of glyricidia leaf green manure at the rate of 3 ton per hectare or 3 to 4 ton per hectare at the time of field preparation. Then 3 to 4 days after transplanting, 2 urea DAP briquettes are the should be recommended for the should be applied 5 cm deep in at the center of the alternate square. It is if necessary, second dose of nitrogen should be given after 15 to 20 days after transplant. Here you can see the resource conservation technologies with respect to fertilizer inputs. We have the can see here that is organically FOM compost at the rate of 10 to 15 tons per hectare should applied at the time of land preparation, and is also the along with glyricidia leaf manure at the rate of 3 to 4 ton per hectare instead of the recommended dose of fertilizer in series method, that is 2 times of the application of the urea DAP briquettes as with the alternate square with the specific depth, that is 5 cm. And then also the second dose of nitrogen should be given 15 to 20 days after transplanting. Next point, we can see here the water management. Regular water application is necessary to keep the moist in this method, that is without flooding. You have to apply water as per the need of the crop or to maintain the alternate wetting and drying conditions. Stagnation or flooding of water in the field should be avoided in the Sri method. And during vegetative stage, field should not be flooded under flooded condition. In the intermediate mid-end wetting and drying conditions are for the adequate aeration is essential for this during this stage. And however, the during grain filling, 1 to 3 centimeter of water may be maintained in the field. Next point, that is weed management. In Sri method, that is hoeing with the rotary weeder is effective for control of weeds. The first hoeing should be done at the 10 days after transplanting, and the 4 hoeing operations are necessary till the panicle initiation stage. Then after weeding, weeds should be buried in the soil as a source of organic matter, and then this adds the organic matter in the soil. Next one, insect pest management. The major rice pest, that is rice stem borer, brown plant hopper, green leaf hopper, leaf folder, or roller, and the gandhi bug are the major pest of rice. And then for control of this pest, especially in the Sri method, there is application of neem seed kernel extract, there is NSKE at the rate of 10 to 15 kg per hectare, and also apply the forehead at the rate of 12 to 15 kg per hectare. Next one, disease management. There is a blast, brown leaf spot, seed blight, stem rot, bacterial leaf blight, tungro virus, Kyra disease are the major diseases of are found in the rice. Our control of these diseases with the help of spraying of carbidazin at the rate of 1 kg per hectare in 1000 liter of water. Then seeds are also treated with the mancozeb at the rate of 3 gram per kg, and the spraying of 5 kg zinc sulfate. The seeds are soaking in sericin followed by hot water treatment. Then harvesting, threshing, and yield. Before that, you can see here the signs of maturity. The yellowing of leaves, stem becomes greenish to yellow or golden in color. Panicle turns green to yellow in color. Grain becomes hard and tough. And then metallic sound comes when the grains are kept under teeth. Then harvest the crop as soon as it matures, or if delayed, grain may lost due to the damage of rats, birds, insects, then as well as avoid the shattering grain lodging. Then timely harvest harvesting ensures the good grain quality. Then right time of stage for the harvesting of rice is when the 80% panicles have the 80% ripen spikelets. And at the time of harvest, the upper portion of the spikelet should be in the straw color, and the grain will contain 20% moisture. The crop is generally cut with the help of serrated edge sickles or bamboo sickles having the serrated margins by hand. It is helpful for the control of insect pests. Then plants should be cut quite close to the ground and left in the field for a few days to dry. Then later on, they should be collected in the bundles and stacked for the threshing. The threshing should be done with the help of beating with the help of stick and the threshing machine, or with the help of bullock trampling. And thresh material should be cleaned properly and dried under sun. And finally, in three method, that is yield obtained, that is 35 to 40 quintals per hectare. And the next point, that is benefits of three method, that is higher yield, both grain and straw. Then reduced duration, that is 10 days over the conventional. Lesser chemical inputs, lesser water requirement, lesser chaffy grains percentage, grain weight increase without change in grain size, then higher head rice recovery, then withstand cyclonic gales, and then cold tolerant soil health improves through the biological activity. These are the benefits of system of rice intensification. This is about today's topic regarding system of rice intensification. Method of rice cultivation. Thank you.